especially those in some places who play golf. I recall very clearly when I was a little bit younger, I entered one man's, you know, the loo in one man's home, and on the top, you know, the shanks, at the top, he had the rules of golf. And wallahi, you won't believe what I'm telling you, but some of you might have seen it because now they sell it on an international scale. They have a small golf green in the toilet, meaning a small little makeshift thing with a mini putter and a golf ball. And whilst you're sitting, you're busy putting. Whilst you're sitting, you're busy putting. I'm not joking. I'm honest with you. You can Google it and check it, but please don't buy it. So they're putting. Why? Because they're wasting their time. We are taught as Muslims, you go to the loo, it is known as liqada al-haja, in order to finish your business. You go in there, you relieve yourself and you come out. There is a dua to read before you enter and as you exit, to ask Allah protection from the devil, because we are taught that sometimes shaitan infests those areas. So you go in and you come out. Please don't play golf in the loo and stop reading magazines and all that in the toilet. I know. So much so that last week someone sent me an image on WhatsApp, and I must share this with you because I just remembered it now. And it showed a man sitting on a pan, and he said, "Oh no, I forgot my phone." You know what that means? That means people have made it their business that before you go to the loo, look for your phone so that you can spend time. Now you're sitting on WhatsApp, messaging people and so on. You know what happened to me a few weeks ago? I can't remember which airport it was, but there was a man speaking inside the toilet. I was waiting to come out, and he's busy having a long conversation. And I wanted to tell him that, hey, finish up your business and get out. There's a queue here, man. And he was like, if you offered him coffee, he probably would have said, okay, thank you very much. This is dangerous. The reason why I'm making mention of it, this is what is overtaking the globe at the moment. People are not understanding what their preferences are. And we were talking about developing a link with Allah. You need to get into the loo and come out of the loo. But remember something, in the same way we get so excited when we have Skype, when we have WhatsApp, when we have so many other types of or other formats. In Far East Asia they have WeChat and they have Line and so on, all these different, you know, Tango and Viber and you name it, it's there. That is good, and mashallah, let's hope we are using it for something beneficial and good. But ask yourself, have I developed a small relation at least with the one who made me? When I go back to him, everything else will remain behind. Everything else will remain behind.
Our objective with this series is to cover various aspects of a Muslim home so we can all have a blessed home, inshallah. Starting from who to get married to and how. What are the roles and responsibilities of a husband and wife towards each other and their children, how and when to complement each other, and lastly, your parents and how best to serve them. For the first time ever, we are going to enable every one of you to learn all about how to achieve a blessed home from Quran and Sunnah with a single click in your own language in state-of-the-art courses, inshallah. The series will consist of 2,000 episodes covering in detail in 3 to 7 minute videos using state-of-the-art animations paired with groundbreaking detailed work. This series is a collaboration with Free Quran Education. The series will be made available in all major languages of the world, inshallah. Now, who will benefit from this? Every single person with internet connection will be able to benefit from the series as long as the internet lasts, inshallah, becoming a source of everlasting constant sadaqah jariyah for everyone who contributes and makes the series a reality by the will of Allah.